The new middle school curriculum for career and technical education is now more hands-on, it's more experiences, and it's also tied very specifically to career paths. The Waterloo Schools Foundation applied for 2 grants last spring, one to the Otto Schweitz Foundation, one to the Community Foundation in Northeast Iowa. The Otto Schweitz Foundation made a $300,000 grant, so without those 2 grants, this project wouldn't have been possible. It's really helped us jumpstart a program that was on the district's radar, but they didn't have the funds to do themselves, to really strengthen what happens then at the high school level too.
As a teacher, it really excites me because the students just get excited about something they haven't had a lot of experience with before. And so to see students who didn't really have a path get excited about something and know that as I progress to high school, there are more opportunities for me, I'm happy to be a part of that.
Well, I think this is good for us to experience this in middle school because when we go on to high school and if someone would like to pursue this future career, this could be a good outlet for them.
So this course is more specific in coding and computer science. It's the only course we've offered that is targeted to that particular skill.
I kind of knew what coding was because I knew like that I created websites and that sort of thing, but I didn't know how to do it or what it was like. But what I like about coding is it's just another thing to express what you like doing. I'm making a website about something I like a lot, and that's just what makes this class fun.
A class like this is important because it just gives kids a platform. It gives them an opportunity to create and own content. There are a lot of jobs out there that used some kind of programming, general problem solving skills. The nonverbal communication is really important. You'll have kids that maybe don't feel comfortable raising their hand in class. They can share their information and they can share their ideas and perspectives through the HTML.
This particular subject shows us how far we need to keep things private. I've always heard, hey, don't do this, and I'm like, oh, okay. But now that I can really see all this stuff, I need to be more careful when it comes to things like this.
Automation and robotics, we start with mechanisms, so things like simple gear train and how 2 gears come together, and when we turn one clockwise, the other one turns counterclockwise, and then we get into some more complicated mechanisms like a cam and follower, which is something you might find in a car, or a crank and slider, which is something you might find in a train. If they're interested in any sort of mechanical engineering, agricultural engineering, anything in those types of fields. I would even say if they want to go into like software engineering, computer engineering as well.
First part you're going to grab right here towards the end of the glove and hook your finger under it.
In medical science class where students will explore into the nursing field, into being doctors and diagnosing patients, doing some work with microbiology, with bacteria plating, we'll do some surgeon work with working with sheep brains and dissecting those. It's an exploration into it because so many kids have an idea that they want to do that, but they haven't had the opportunities.
So the Waterloo Career Center, it's no surprise, that's kind of exploded in the district and it's become a priority because when students are involved in career and technical education, they're more likely to graduate and also have the tools they need to be successful in college and in their career. This is a way to also show them stuff that exists at the Career Center. So it's a way to kind of prime them and get them excited about a variety of different career opportunities.
So everything really makes a nice transition from 6th grade to 7th grade to 8th grade in order to kind of pique interest for kids. That way when they reach the Career Center, they can take some of the classes that they have.
Every quarter I've taken all of my 6th and 8th grade students over there to work with one of their teachers, and they teach us how to use gait belts, they teach us how to, if somebody's falling, how to catch them with the gait belts. It's a good day.
She got taught something, and she did it, and now she's teaching somebody else. I love that. That's great learning.
I think one of the biggest things that I teach is, and I teach this in all of my classes, not just robotics, but how to be a good problem solver. I was working with kids this morning. They were getting frustrated when they built something and it didn't quite work the right way, and I would instruct them to pull it apart and make some adjustments and put it back together. And that's a frustrating thing to learn, but that's what a good problem solver is. It's someone who can identify the problem, take it apart, fix the problem, and put it back together again. And that applies to pretty much anything in life, robotics or otherwise.
Well, in the world, it's all about failure. I mean, everyone has to fail sometime, and that's how you succeed. So I think learning how to fail right now is gonna help you not like be devastated by it and just accept failure.
I've had students who think this isn't for them who are now all of a sudden excited about it because they know that they're able to do it. So it's really opened, I think, a lot of opportunity for kids who didn't know anything about coding or careers in computer science.
one of the main reasons why we believe in career and technical education is it's been proven to help raise graduation rates. So we felt like this was a priority to really help the students in our school district not only survive academically, but really thrive and find something that they're passionate about.